See the models here of the neighborhood of make-believe? Who lives in here? In the castle. And who works in this factory? Cornflake especially. And who lives in this tree? Henrietta and X the owl. Do you remember what happened to Bob Dog yesterday when he was climbing up at this tree? Climbing up on a ladder to get a ball up here at X's tree. He fell and he had to go to the hospital. Well, King Friday got so worried about people getting hurt that he made a rule that no one was allowed to play in this neighborhood anymore. How do you think people will feel if they're not allowed to play anymore? I think we should think about that now.
We cannot continue to rely only on our military in order to achieve the national security objectives that we've set. We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded.
Fish are using their mouths to eat. They seem to be hungry every day. What are some things that people's mouths do? They eat. They sing. Can you sing? They yawn. They whistle. I hope you can grow up to whistle better than I. They whisper. Yes, they whisper. And they hum. And they laugh. We've talked about all those things, haven't we? One thing that people's mouths do that most other creatures don't do is say words like I'm saying words to you right now.
One time I wished that a dragon would come and burn up my daddy's big store. I was angry with him 'cause I wanted to play. But my daddy just went to his store right away. I wished that that dragon would burn that store. I wished it would burn Daddy's store.
I have a puppet that I want to show you. This puppet has a big mouth with teeth. People must not bite other people. But if they ever feel like doing that, they can play about it. When I was a little boy, I used to play a lot with puppets like this. I played a lot about my feelings. In fact, playing about feelings is a great thing for people to learn how to do. And many children are very good players. Make-believe is a kind of play, you know? So let's just have some make-believe.
What action placing a tracking microchip under a service member's skin? Former U.S. Special Operations
officers tell us they believe that's being developed. Current military officials won't comment on that, Wolf.
Yeah, what about the cost, Brian? Is that at all a consideration?
It's a big consideration. Just about every former officer I spoke with says the cost of outfitting each combat troop with a tracking
device is one of the main reasons they don't have them right now. So when you speak with
the various special operations types and others, and I know you've been doing a lot of reporting on this, the pros and cons of having these kinds of
tracking devices, what do they say, Brian? Some believe that every service member should have them. Some don't because of the risks we talk about. But others say if they can deal with the cost and pay for all of this, it is worth it not only to track missing troops, but to be able to tell friendlies from enemies on the battlefield. Ragtag reporting
Such devices, by the way, are not just tools for war. They're also tools that could keep all of us and all of our families safe.
When you're feeling angry or sad, or maybe when something makes you feel afraid, do you ever make up a dance and stomp your feet or punch an old pillow? Or do you have a loud song that you can sing when you're angry? Here's some loud music, which just sounds like it's saying, I'm angry. I'm very, very angry.
Tiger. And if I'm a tiger, then I'm in your family, and I can be related to you.
Oh, you're part of my family no matter what you are.
I am?
Sure. It doesn't matter what you look like on the outside.
It doesn't?
No. You and I are related by our hearts.
Our hearts are related?
Of course. That's the way it is with a family of friends. They don't look alike. They feel for each other. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel better. Why?
Because you look like your Lady Aberlin self again.
I do.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't feel anything.
Because it's natural. It's real natural.
You are special, Daniel Tiger.
Thanks, Lady Aberlin.
Lady Aberlin! Everybody's been looking for you everywhere. Where have you been?
Oh, I've been around.
Oh, I'm glad I finally found you. I have a research job for you.
Oh, Zelda, you do know my relative Daniel Tiger, don't you?
Oh, sure. Hi, Daniel.
Hi, Princess Zelda.
Say, I've seen that sticker someplace before. I know. It was on that big tiger's forehead. Now, that's something to do some research about.
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Thank you.
Is that fun?
It sure is. It takes a lot of work, but it's worth it because it's so much fun after you worked on your instrument and you know how to do it.
Well, sure. I also told my television friend that you don't see with your eyes.
That's right. And it's not because I saw anything bad or anything like that.
Why do you say that?
Well, some people think that just because you're curious that you can become blind. Well, that's just not so.
Well, that's certainly good to know. You say it's just not so.
It's just not so.
What, too. Yeah, what's this?
This is a stalactite. Feel this.
Oh, it's smooth, like glass or marble.
It's made of layers and layers of stone. When the water drips down, the water has in it tiny little pieces of stone.
Uh-huh.
And that stone goes on to this one and makes it larger and larger. And when the water drips off, it goes all the way down and makes a stalagmite.
This is a stalagmite here?
Yes.
And then
it grows. And when they come together, they make a column.
A column?
Mm-hmm.
You're a good teacher, Betty.
Thanks.
Won't you please, won't you be my neighbor? Hi, neighbor. Do you sometimes sing that with me? Please, won't you be my neighbor? I hope you do. Look at this. This is something I brought to play with.
It's a dildo!
That's what they teach. That's what they want you to be. They don't want laws against sexual promiscuity. That's why they don't want families. That's why they don't want marriage. That's why they encourage homosexuality. There's a method to their madness. There's really not much method to yours. because you're operating from a place of ignorance. And until you change that, you're going to be bumbling around, bumping into each other, saying and doing the wrong things, not understanding the nature of your enemy. And if you don't understand the nature of your enemy and the weapons they use, you cannot fight that enemy.
When people say they love you, that can give you a very good feeling. But when they do things that show you that they love you, that can give you some of the best feelings of all.
It's else but you and me together. Sometimes it's like that with one of your parents. Hugs don't sound much, do they? But kisses do. Could you make a kissing sound? I'll make one too. Here's a kiss that's just for you.
Man.
Here, take this out of context, okay?
I'll show you what's going to fit in that hole. It's in my pocket here.
All right, that can't be right.